You know, Falguni, I just want to get a clarification on the valuation part because last year in March, you had given you had allotted to a private equity at 201 rupees. In June, you had allotment to the promoter family at 359 rupees odd, and now we are pricing the IPO at roughly around 1125, which is the upper end of the price band. From $2.2 billion, the valuation has now close to $7 billion. That's the reason I'm asking, how do you justify that $7 billion valuation?
So I think if you look at the fundraise that we did from last external investor, which was done during April, it was a COVID impacted month. You know, I think the transaction was being considered at a time when COVID had hit us, and I think from certain perspective, you know, we saw need to really bolster our resources ahead of what we would have liked to do then. And at that point, certain other investors also wanted to, some of our existing investors wanted to place at least some amount of their stock. So I think that valuation was right in the context then. Since then, I think Nykaa has continued to grow during even COVID impacted times. And all of that, those numbers are in the prospectus. So even between financial year 2019 to 21, we've grown at a CAGR. GMV has grown at a CAGR of 56.6% in spite of COVID impacted year. In the prospectus, we've also shared the quarter one number for financial year 22, where I think on beauty itself, we've grown 12% quarter on quarter from fourth quarter last year, or 178% year on year growth in beauty. And in fashion also, we have grown 43% quarter on quarter, and of course, 9x from previous year comparisons. So April, May, June of 2022, financial year 22, has been, in spite of being again COVID phase two impacted, our business has been very strong. Also, over the last 1.5-2 years, we've set up a fashion business, you know, which has scaled very, very nicely over that period. I think in the fashion business, we have grown, you know, at a very, very fast pace and got established. So I think all of that is reflected in the valuation. As far as the promoter placement is concerned, it is more like it came out of a issuance to the promoters done 3 years ago. And these things were subject to reaching certain milestones on growth, profitability and turnover. And, you know, I mean, mainly on turnover and also growth. And you know, certain milestones that the company was meant to achieve. So as you are aware that these things are issued at, you know, valuation, which were at that point in time, 3 years ago, and they can be exercised 3-4 years later. So the exercise has happened now, but the issuance was done a couple of years ago.